So for me, I get asked the question all the time, like, hey, Notion, this thing's going to make you really productive. It's going to make you so productive. It's going to make you the most productive person possible, right? Let's get into Notion. Let's get my business into Notion. Let's get my personal workflow into Notion. Let's get my dog into Notion. I don't know. People go crazy about it. So I don't even want to get into Notion from a, you know, like structural, like, hey, look how good this thing is. I want to talk about why I'm actually so productive in the fact that I've used Notion. If you wait till the end of this video, I actually give you one Notion tip, just one, that will actually make you much more productive. But for starters, let's talk about the three core components of productivity and why I'm good at it outside of literally the practical things within Notion. Number one, I have a system. Who would have thought? Having a system tangibly does something for you that really matters. If you do not have a system within something like Notion or other applications, you're not going to get a lot of work done. It's like going into a game and not having any sort of game plan. I don't know if you guys play American sports or I'll do two examples. One, if in football, you end up going into a plan where you have no scheme on offense or defense, or say, for example, you get a lead, you have no idea what you end up doing. Are you going to park the bus and keep all your players back and prevent them from scoring? Or are you going to be more aggressive even when you have a lead? If you have no idea what you're going to end up doing in American football and you're just going back and forth between running plays and pass plays, you have no idea how that's setting up the offense for success. In this case, if you have no plan and you're just kind of putting tasks in places and you have no system that you're practicing, you are not going to be productive. If I had a system from a Notion standpoint where it was very pretty, it had all the databases, it had all the things, and then I had no methodology to how I spend my time towards it, which would be number two, that would be bad. So step one, have a system for how you organize different tasks, projects, and priorities. Number two, organize your time. I was on a call recently with a potential client who was talking about, I just want to overhaul my system. And I went, okay, but like, how do you prioritize your time? Because I think the majority of your problem is not the fact that you don't have a good system. Your system's okay. You just complained about doing natural language processing in Todoist from like a how long it takes perspective. And that's one of the quickest applications out there. So my question was, is this guy just not prioritizing his time well and not allowing for any self time blocks? For example, if you're in a workplace that doesn't do nice things like mine does, where they literally do not have meetings set until 11 a.m. And for me, it's like, that's 2 hours of unimpeded work that I can focus on performance, which is like the core thing of the job. If you do not allow your time to be prioritized in a way where the core work is getting done uninterrupted, then you're gonna not be productive. It's not about Notion, it's about the fact that I have a system that works. One, I have a time schedule that is uninterrupted in the mornings. And then number three, I have low friction for accessing all of those things. So whether it being the systemized way that I look at tasks, ideas, projects, which is the system of like the second brain para, that's my first step. And then number two, I have the time blocking as my time organization. Number three is I have very low friction from interacting between all those three different things. And what that means is you need to have a place on your phone, you need to have a place on your computer, and you need to have sort of a mental map of how things are going all the time. In order to decrease the cognitive load that you have on yourself, knowing where everything is going to be housed consistently in your business or in your own personal workflow can be really impacted by the quality of the organization and the friction that you have between your first two parts of this. If I have a great system and a great time blocking methodology that doesn't allow me to see it in my face ever, I'm gonna have to think too hard about what was done when, and I'm just gonna try too hard to find where it is on my computer or my phone, and then I'm gonna cry, and that no one wants to see that. In order to decrease the friction that you're gonna have in Notion though, I built out a system that is based off of the Josh Red's perspectives method that is going to be groundbreaking. It's a template where you can essentially go and navigate through the entirety of the system utilizing the different linked databases that exist now, where you can go to layout and set the feature to open pages and full page. And by having like a settings page in the back end, I'm able to organize this navigation bar and have it be across the entire system. Rather than having this clunky thing or having synced headers at the top, you're gonna have consistent views to things that matter, which reduces the friction even more. And that's another secret as to how I'm hyper productive. If you wanna be more productive or see more videos like this, check out that one. You're gonna need this one specifically. This one's important.